So the backstory, not to drag you through every technical detail, but there was sort of a hack on Japanese phones years ago where they were pretty basic sort of flip phones, and someone came up with the idea that, oh, we can fit these extra little characters in text messages. And what happened is that Google wanted to take Gmail to Japan, and the Japanese market, they said, look, we're not going to do Gmail unless emojis work in Gmail. And they weren't going to work because they were sort of this Japanese-only thing and they wouldn't work. So Google went to Unicode, the standards body, and they said, look, we just need to make this happen. Got Apple on board, and then next thing we know, we all got them on our own phones because of Gmail going to Japan.
Because of that, because of those, I think, distinctly Japanese origins, does that basically explain why we have so many weird emoji, like ramen and tempura, and now zombies and elf?
Well, you can't blame Japan for the zombies and elves of this year. That's past Japan. But people always complain to me about the 12 trains. I always get, why are there 12 trains and there isn't a redhead? I see a few redheads around the room. So, yeah, and they're because of Japan that they were used to train timetables a lot in the weather. So you see a lot of those sort of Japanese influence and Japanese foods and map markers. There's the red one with sort of wavy lines above it.
Yeah, what is that?
Well, it's for like an onsen or hot springs in Japan.
Right. Yes.
They put it on a map.
Super applicable to everybody.
Exactly. We all use that so well. So, yeah, you're right. A lot of the weird looking stuff to the rest of us are because they're on the Japanese ones.